Hey, I'm Tommy Shaw from the rock band Styx, and you are watching Life Minute TV.
Legendary rock group Styx has just released their 17th studio album, Crash of the Crown, and they're taking it on the road for legions of adoring fans, old and new. We were fortunate to catch up with frontman Tommy Shaw, responsible for so much of Styx's legendary sounds. This is a Life Minute with Tommy Shaw.
It's going to be big and loud. It's going to sound great because we have a killer audio team. And we try to create like an art. It comes on big and then it kind of settles down and then it gets big again. And sometimes we do two sets, so we play an hour and take a 20-minute break and come back and start all over again. And so you get two arcs like that. And a lot of guys singing high harmonies, and it's just weird that everybody can still do it. I still can't believe that I can still hit all those high notes. Then there's guys in the band can do it too. So that's the that's always been a Styx thing, is the three-part harmonies. Is it any wonder I've
got too much time on my hands? So tell us about the new album.
And Will Evankovich, who's the producer of the record, Will and I, we didn't really have any projects, we were just writing. And then little by little, it was like, you know, this sounds like it's starting to be a Styx album. He was full of surprises, you know. He's not just a guitar player, singer, songwriter. He's almost like a George Martin kind of guy, because he can write string charts and he does great impressions of Todd Zimmerman on the digital drums when we do demos. It's just been a rebirth having Will join. Now he's joined the band. You know, there's just new music is still coming to us, and hopefully it always will. The fun thing about music is if you let it lead you to the next thing, generally it will take you to the right place.
Do you think like the old Styx fans who like only know the old stuff, are they receptive to the new stuff too?
They have been. You know, it's a really, really good album. The thing that we wanted to hear from reviews was this album stands up next to the Equinox, Grand Illusion, and Pieces of Eight. Because those were iconic, and those were the albums where everything worked out right. You know, they did everything right, and they resonated with fans and still do. And it happened. That's when I started doing interviews. That's what they were saying. This is you know, the best thing since Pieces of Eight. Touring now, and we're booked until the end of next year, and there's a lot of interesting stuff going on. And we're going to be doing a couple of shows where we play entire albums. The fans love that. You know, it's the newer stuff. We've done a couple of older albums back to back, and it's fun to do that because people know the albums, and it's something to just see it blown up into a live performance. It's so nice to be up on stage and having the kind of problems that you run into every day with rehearsals and figuring out what we're going to play. And then it's exciting. You got to show up and you got to hit the notes. You got to hit your marks and, you know, you got to communicate. And when you suit up at 8 o'clock, it's like superpowers. You know, you get whatever was going on during the day, you have to forget about it. And you just have to dig down and do your part. And our music requires some gusto to deliver it, you know, because it's a lot of soulful singing, especially playing the new stuff. Todd Zimmerman on drums, he's one of the top drummers in the world right now. If you go on Todd Zimmerman's Facebook page, he does videos where he plays along with the album, so you'll see what he's doing. And he's phenomenal. Ricky Phillips on bass, and he knows everybody. He played with Jimmy Page and Lawrence Gowan. He's a Canadian treasure there. He was an 80s star. You know, it's a fun band to be in. You can't have a bad night in that band. You don't want to be the guy who's having a rough night. It's everything. It's what we were meant to do. You can just tell when you pick up the guitar and you just put your fingers somewhere or tune it differently. And you do something, and then it leads you to another thing that's like part of a conversation. I personally have sat down and poured my heart into just what was happening at the second. And all those vibrations went through that guitar. So when I pick up one of those, it's like this thing is a soul machine. that's one of the coolest things about what we do is we make something from nothing.
Who are some of your influences on the guitar, or any other, like, you know, guitarists that you just loved or still enjoy now?
I was a Beatles kid, you know, so I always enjoyed how George Harrison played. I still do, you know, he grew as he went along, and I love his slide guitar playing. I love Derek Trucks. He's a big inspiration. I didn't lift anything, but I enjoy his style so much. A song called Coming Out the Other Side that I was doing my best Derek Trucks impression on the slide.
The charity Rock to the Rescue. Tell us about that too.
We get local grassroots nonprofits involved with our show. They help us sell CDs. We give them a chunk of the money from the CD, and it's usually their biggest donation of the year. It's just a fun way for us to give back. At the end of the evening, they keep their ticket stubbed. They will have a drawing, and we give away a signed and autographed electric guitar from the band.
So what do you like to do when you're not working?
We're bird nerds at our house. We're ornithologists, and because where we live, if you pay attention, there's really lots of beautiful birds. And Jeannie and I just discovered that about each other, that we've always been like that. And lots of wildlife, lots of deer and squirrels and rabbits. And we have a groundhog named Harry.
But how do you take care of yourself?
I exercise. Just, you know, I have things around that are like little stations I can walk by and exercise. And I was working out with a trainer 5 days a week during the pandemic, just so I didn't lose my mind. But once I got busy with the band again, I didn't have all the free time. So I got to just do things when I can. And I one thing I do is I take the stairs in hotels.
What's something you don't travel without, or that you always travel with?
I always have a snark. This clips onto the end of the guitar neck, this thing right here.
Oh, neat. Okay.
And the vibrations show up on a meter, and you can tune your guitar. I got this online one time, and my wife says, this is kind of weird that you have this, but they, you know, there was this little thing to have a proper tourniquet. It could save somebody's life. This little thing,
oh, wow.
You know. And if you wouldn't have a rope or something, this is like a bona fide tourniquet.
Since it's Life Minute, if you had to give us one of life's most valuable lessons or life advice, what would it be?
Listen to your mother. All the things my mother used to tell me, and I'm like, oh, you don't, you know, she would say, next year's going to be better. And she's right. It's always been better. I was the baby, and my two older brothers were like 9 and 10 years older. They played sports, and they got hurt playing football. She wanted me to be the artist in the band, in the family. I remember my grandfather, who was retired, and he would pick or get the money out of the newspaper machines and stock it with newspapers. So he always had a pocket full of nickels. So he would pay me a nickel to sing any kind of a song. So my sister and brothers were always listening to the radio. And so I would sing, you know, anything I could remember, and I didn't get a nickel. So I was basically a professional musician as a toddler.
To hear more of this interview, visit our podcast, Life Minute TV, on iTunes and all streaming podcast platforms.